Hi everyone, thanks for watching my YouTube contents. I'm Sangwoo Kim. In this video, I'm going to show you how to get Breslow estimation with ties for Cox proportional hazard analysis in XLNR. In the previous video, I showed you how to get Cox pH coefficients by using ovarian data. And for this video, I actually added three more samples and colored it by green. There's one reference site I have used for this video. So when you have tide events like this, Cox pH fit approximates the partial likelihood of the model by either Breslow's method or inference method. The simplest approximation method is Breslow's method. This method uses the same denominator for each tide set. In our program, if you specify tides option in Cox pH function, then you can get Breslow coefficients for Rx and Ah. Cox pH use Breslow option as default. Right, let me show you how to get Breslow coefficients in Excel. So again, for example, assume that the first two events are tied, that is T1 equals T2, and ascending order from T2 to Tn. In Breslow method, the denominators of the first two terms are the same. Please mind this formula. Then let's firstly get Cox pH coefficients in Excel. So invert. Comma. Coefficients, and press Ctrl Shift Enter, and exponential of x beta can be calculated by using exponential function, and log likelihood for each observation if you set equals 1, then x beta minus log of sum of exponential x beta. Then you need to fix the last cell. Okay. Then if veto equals is not equal to 1, then let's give a value as 0. Control C and Control V. Then again, sum of low likelihoods. Okay. Then we want to actually maximize this sum of low likelihoods by changing this one. Okay. And uncheck this option and click solve. Right. So this is actually Cox pH coefficients, right? We haven't considered this tied option in log likelihood. Again, please remember that the denominator must be same. So let's change the log likelihood for tied samples. So again, we need to use same denominator. So it has got another same data for a few time. So let's change this to F4, this one. Okay, and for this one, because this observation actually has same FL time, so we also need to change it. Okay. This one. Right, then let's find again coefficients by maximizing this one. Server, and let's click it again. Okay, as you can see, it has been changed and is very similar to this one, our output. I guess the small difference actually comes from different optimization algorithm, right? In our program, we actually use Newton-Raphson algorithm, but in Excel, it actually used this GRG nonlinear algorithm. Right? But the main thing, what I wanted to say in this video is to help you understand how to get row likelihood when there are ties data. I hope it was useful to understand how to get Breslow estimation for Cox proportional hazard analysis with ties. Please click like and subscribe if it was useful for you. Thank you.